Now what? Now what? What's that? What?
I have a major announcement. After 15 years of teaching English professionally, I have decided, as of today, to end my English teaching career so that I can become a professional vibe coder. All right, I'm not actually retiring, but I have been spending a lot of time vibe coding in Gemini 3, specifically vibe coding English learning experiences. I have a lot of ideas about how to help English learners improve, and now that there's a tool, Gemini 3, that allows me to do that without banging my head against the wall, I'm going to make stuff. I'm not saying that everything that I create will become available for everybody to use, although some things will. A lot of people want to use the pronunciation tool I created. I'm working on releasing that. It just needs to be tuned up a bit. In this video, I want to show you something I've been working on that I think is pretty cool and pretty useful. Now, I think the best thing to do if you think it's pretty cool would be to simply build it yourself. Take inspiration from this and maybe develop it further and create something even more cool on your own. I think that is the best outcome. By the way, if you haven't already done so, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe. I would really appreciate that. And check out the 90-day program in the links in the description. If you're watching this during Black Friday, then the Black Friday sale is still live. And that's a crazy 25% off the 90-day program price, which is, I don't know how I feel about doing 25% off. That's so maybe a little too much. Anyway, check that out. So what have I created here? Well, it's a game. Okay, so let's just jump in and I'll show you how it works. So on the top right there, you see five circles. We need to collect five stones. The first four are on this main land mass, and there's one more on another one that we can't reach because there's a waterway in the middle. So what happens is when we collect the first four, we then have a way to lower the water level so that we can walk across to get the fifth. Now, how do we get a stone? Do we just pick it up? No. So these are connected to AIs behind the scenes, each stone. I just made it a stone because then I don't have to try to figure out how to do 3D characters and GLB files and stuff. Where the heck is the, it's over here. Oh, there it is over there. Okay, so I just made these stones, and when you interact with the stone and complete a challenge, an English challenge, in order to pick it up. Basically, that's how it works. So let's try it out.
Light goes everywhere. We want to go up, but first we need to think about ourselves.
What does that even mean? I could do speech to text using my keyboard. I'll do that for longer answers. And you can see the progress bar is starting to fill up. And also there's an expression here, walking on air.
Oh, hi. Forget that for a bit. I have a question. What is your favorite memory of a sunny day?
Favorite memory of a sunny day? And then I'm assuming I have to use the expression walking on air. Okay, let's try it. My favorite recent sunny day memory was actually in the early autumn. There's a lake not far from my house with a kind of Asian stone garden around it. And while there were a lot of gnats flying around, my family and I had a great day just exploring the garden, and then we set up our pop-up tent and we had a picnic overlooking the lake. And it was very surreal, and I felt like I was kind of detached from the rest of the world, just surrounded by nature, a sense that I was walking on air. Okay, looks like I completed the task successfully. Let's see what happens.
Oh, that sounds so lovely. A picnic by the lake. And you used my phrase, walking on air. That's great. You did it.
Thank you so much. Why is that cursor there? That's okay. We don't worry about it. Next, we need to go to, I think we can find the blue one. I believe we're headed the right way. So again, we collect with four different interactions with AIs. We then collect four stones, which, don't ask why, allows us to magically lower the water level so that we can get across. The thing that happens at the end is crazy, or should be. I haven't actually completed it. So this is going to be as much of a surprise to me as it is to you. I haven't completed the finished game. We'll see what happens.
I help people remember things. To move on, we need to show we know where we came from.
Sounds fine to me. How do we do that?
We do that by sharing a story. Tell me about a time you tried something that felt too hard. See if you can use the words in over my head.
There's this really well-known book called Finnegan's Wake that is famously very difficult to read. And I took that as a challenge, and so I said to myself, I'll read this dang book. I can read any book there is. Then I tried. I started. And I barely made it through two pages before I thought to myself, what is happening? I don't understand anything in this book, and I'm definitely not going to finish it. I was in way over my head. I was in over my head. I think I have to use the phrase exactly so I can make that improvement to make it a little bit more flexible. There's basically a word count behind the scenes and then a check mark if you use the phrase correctly.
That's a great story. You did it. You used the words. We can move on now.
Fantastic. Got the blue stone and we've got the yellow stone. We need two more stones on this landmass and then we can cross the thingy. There it is. There's the green stone. Come on, green stone. Help me.
Growth takes time. We can only move up when we can say clearly who we are.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
That is kind of you to say. I like hearing about new beginnings. Have you ever tried turning over a new leaf?
There was a period of time where I was going to bed later and later. There would be days when I would go to bed at 3, 4, sometimes even 5 in the morning, which was pretty crazy. And I decided it wasn't good for me, it wasn't healthy. So I began turning over a new leaf by making a hard, strict bedtime at midnight. And it's extremely ironic that I'm saying this recording at 4 in the morning. And the idea for this, I think, also is nice. I think it failed to call the voice response. That's okay. Okay, where to next? Go over this snow-covered mountain here. I see a glowing stone over here. The last stone. Come on, stone. Come on, rock. Tell me what you've got.
Being strong isn't enough here. You need to use your words, not force.
I agree. I think in the future, what would be cool would be to add more criteria. So you have to talk for a while. It's more conversational, but there are different criteria kind of woven into the conversation organically. And it feels like a real conversation, but you have to meet certain sort of check certain boxes in order to pass challenges. So you're being challenged, you're being pushed, but it's also like a real conversation. So this is, I think, a very simple version of that. Very simple. Too simple. If I get interested in a topic, it becomes almost an obsession for me. I have a burning desire to understand it, read about it, and eventually put something together using the knowledge that I've learned, like an article or something like that. I can't explain why I have to do that or why it's so obsessive for me, but that's just how I've always been. I didn't say enough yet.
That's a strong desire. Give me more details.
I think most of my interests are related to learning things that may not necessarily be practical, but things which catch my interest. And once I find something that catches my interest, I can't really look away. I have to pursue it.
Good. You have proved yourself.
Hey, that was a different sound. I think we can do something else now. Oh, there's a glowing thing. Let's go over to the glowing thing. So you can see we cannot cross this water. I know it looks shallow, but can't go across. So what we have to do is we have to now, this was not there before. This was activated when I got 4 stones. Now I walk into this. And the waters recede. Now I climb up the other side to find the 5th and final stone. And that's when it gets crazy. Well, maybe. In theory. Again, I haven't seen it. I'm not sure. There it is.
You have found the others. Now you are here at the end.
So true.
You found all the stones. Good. Now, tell me, which other stone did you like best? Why? Also, try to use the words, the bigger picture.
I enjoyed talking to all of the other stones, which is a sentence I've never uttered before, but I would have to say recalling the summer day was probably the easiest to talk about, and maybe that's just because it's a vivid memory. Overall, the bigger picture of talking to all four stones gives me a more nuanced understanding of myself, and I appreciate that each interaction had a kind of theme, and I would love that to be developed further. I would love to talk to those dang stones again someday. As the sun rises.
You like them all. You saw the bigger picture. That is good. We are done.
That is good. We are done. Wow, we're done? What happens next? Now what happens? Now what? Now what? Now what? What's that? What? What is that? A stairway? Whoa. What the heck? Would I just climb up on it? All right, here we go. Climbing up the stairs. Bye, world. I had a nice time. Nice to meet all the cool stones. I enjoyed it. Take care. Feel a sense of accomplishment. I got to practice my English. Thank you all so much. But goodbye, clouds. Goodbye, tree. Goodbye, little trees that all look exactly the same. Goodbye, procedurally generated water. Well, what? I mean, where am I going? Just disappearing. I'm going to walk forward. Jeez, this is a tall staircase. What the heck is gonna be at the top? How long is this going to go on? Well, the world is pretty much gone behind me. All right. This is an insanely... What is happening?
5 minutes later.
Oh, there's something up there. Well, that's complete. There's nothing back there. What is this? What is that? This is new. I mean, I haven't been here. I haven't done this. I prompted something, but I wasn't sure what was going to happen. Let's see. My God, this is the longest flight of stairs I've ever climbed in my whole life. Enough stairs. Looks like a floating island of some kind. Maybe some pine trees on top. Okay, can we just walk through? Maybe jump? Oh, we just jump up there. All right, so we're on this island. Can we look down at this? Okay, there's our wonderful staircase that I was climbing for like 15 minutes. That was crazy. Okay, there appear to be some trees here. A black rock of some... What is that? What is that? That reminds me of the obelisk from 2001 A Space Odyssey. Holy cow. Is that what that is? What is this? I'm just playing around at this point with Gemini 3, just experimenting to see what's possible. So if this inspires you or gets the wheels moving a little bit, don't be afraid to try it yourself. I really think this is a new form of creativity. And I also think a very interesting way to work on English skills, a lot of different skills, based on exactly what you need in the moment, right? Eventually, it's going to be an instant thing that's just there exactly when you need it and exactly what you need. For now, we have to decide what we want and then build it ourselves. But I think that process is also pretty fun, especially in my opinion, with Gemini 3. Vibe coding in Gemini 3 is, I think, a really fun and playful process. If you have other ideas that you want me to try to build, let me know in the comments. If you have ideas to develop this game further and you want me to add something or try something, let me know in the comments. If you're interested in playing it or maybe a future version of this game, again, let me know in the comments. If you haven't done so already, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Get a free course in the links in the description. And of course, check out the 90-day program. Right now is the Black Friday sale. If you're watching this during Black Friday until I think Saturday is when it ends, the 90-day program has a 25% discount. That is a very big discount, and that's really not something I do very often. So make sure to grab it if you can. Otherwise, check it out. I think it's a really great way to improve your spoken English skills. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.